Hello, welcome back to today's first video, doing 5D forecast for today's first video. As always, on a Wednesday, we're having a detailed look at the weather for the next 5 days. Coming up later on today, we'll extend out beyond the 5-day forecast period and have a look at the weather for the next week to 10 days. We will also include the Beijing climate scene next 40 days in that, so that will take us pretty much in towards the end of August. And then this evening we might do storm watch actually, because I think the threat of thunderstorms is beginning to increase now. And it may start as early as tomorrow, but particularly sort of late tomorrow and then through into Friday, we could have some thunderstorms around. It's looking a little bit more positive now compared to the letdown that we had at the end of last week. We were supposed to have thunderstorms at the end of last week and we never really turned up. I think this one's a little bit more interesting. So we might do storm watch later on this evening. And today's second video between 5 to 4 o'clock and that, we'll have a look at the weather for the next week to 10 days as usual. But kicking it all off is the 5D forecast. So to say about websites using 5D forecasts coming from theweatherout.com and wettercentral.tv. Find the links to both those websites on the links page. So this is the radar picture from the Weather Outlook, and there's loads of dry weather around today. We have got a little bit of showery rain across the far north and northwest of Scotland. But other than that, it's a dry, or has been a dry morning, pretty much across the whole of the country. And we can see from the pressure chart that high pressure is still more or less in control. We have got low pressure out to the west and northwest of the country, but we've got this big ridge extending through the UK still and going up towards Scandinavia, and we're also starting to bring hotter air back up from the south again, and that will be particularly the case of course this afternoon. So, for the rest of this afternoon, we'll keep showery bursts of rain going across the far north and northwest of Scotland. Otherwise, a little bit of showery rain might get in towards Northern Ireland, but the rest of the country will stay dry and we'll have a mix of sunny spells and variable cloud. Probably more cloud around generally than we've had for a few days, but even so, I think there will be decent sunny spells coming through. Temperatures in the south are going to get hot this afternoon, going up to around 31 degrees. That's 88 Fahrenheit in the southeast. Elsewhere, seeing temperatures sort of mid to upper 20 Celsius across parts of the Midlands. And then we go a bit towards Scotland. It is a little bit cooler up there, with temperatures into below 20 Celsius for Scotland and Northern Ireland. Overnight tonight, that patchy rain will clear away from the far north and northwest of Scotland. Most places will turn dry under this ridge of high pressure. The wind is turning to the south or southeast, so we begin to drag much warmer air up from the continent. It's going to be a warm and humid night down in the south, with temperatures in central London, for example, possibly not falling any lower, around 21 degrees. 21 is 70 Fahrenheit, so it'll be an uncomfortable night for sleeping down in the south, particularly in the cities. Most places dry with clear spells and variable cloud through the course of tonight. So into tomorrow, Thursday, we've got high pressure over Scandinavia. We've got low pressure out in the Atlantic, and we're bringing up this very warm, hot, southerly, southeasterly wind. There is some really hot temperatures across northeastern parts of France and the Low Countries tomorrow, and some of that might just clip in across the very far southeast. But at the same time, the air is becoming more unstable as this low pressure gets ever closer towards us, so the atmosphere will be wobbling, and that might start to set off some heavy thundery showers. We'll find a band of rain across Ireland through the course of Thursday morning, and that's going to head in towards western parts of Scotland through the course of Thursday afternoon. So that could be quite heavy and thundery, perhaps affecting southwest Scotland as well by the end of the afternoon. Otherwise, we'll have plenty of sunny spells coming through during the morning, hot sunshine, but then the afternoon could see scattered thunderstorms breaking out across central and eastern parts of the country. I think generally quite hit and miss with these storms tomorrow afternoon, but through parts of the Midlands, up towards East Anglia, Lincolnshire, Yorkshire, both of the areas, there might be some quite heavy showers or thunderstorms setting off later tomorrow afternoon. The southeast probably mostly dry and very hot. Temperatures could be up to 34 degrees in the southeast tomorrow afternoon. That is 93 Fahrenheit. Otherwise, temperatures range around 30 to 32. So that's kind of like getting towards 90 Fahrenheit. It will feel very hot and humid down in the south and the southeast. That's Friday. And the low pressure is getting ever closer to us from off the Atlantic. If I show you the upper air temperatures, you see there is a big temperature contrast on Friday. Very hot air just to our east and clipping in across the extreme southeast. Much cooler air out to the west. And these air masses are battling it out on Friday. The battle lines are drawn. And so we could see some heavy showers and thunderstorms breaking out. We probably see more storms coming more widespread, actually, across central and eastern parts of the country overnight Thursday into Friday. Some of those storms could still be rumbling around in the east on Friday morning, but I think they'll generally die down through the course of the morning as we see this band of cloud and rain across Ireland and the Irish Sea area moving into other western parts of the country through the morning. And then the showers to the east of that band of rain probably ease down through the morning. But then in the afternoon, it could all start to get going again. So Friday afternoon could see big showers or thunderstorms breaking out across central and eastern parts of the UK in particular, particularly for eastern counties. We could see some big storms on Friday afternoon. But we will look at this in more detail in Storm Watch. Now, eventually, much cooler, fresher air is going to arrive in the west. So could be one of those days where the highest temperatures for western areas happen early in the morning, and then the temperatures drop off through the course of the afternoon, probably finishing up at around 20 degrees around Northern Ireland, southwestern Scotland. But over in the east, it'll be another hot day. And just how hot it gets will depend on how much sunshine there is, how many thunderstorms there are. If there's lots of storms and a lot of cloud, then it will limit the temperature potential, but it will be very warm and humid. It'll be a very humid day. But if the storms are quite scattered, if there's a lot of sunshine, then for parts of East England and South East England, 35, maybe 36 degrees is not out of the question on Friday. That's an exceptionally hot 95 to 96 or 7 Fahrenheit. So really, really hot across East Anglia and the extreme southeast of England. If the sun comes out for long enough and we don't get too many thunderstorms. Otherwise, we're sort of low 30s Celsius if there's a lot of cloud and storms rumbling around. Now, by the time we go through to Saturday, we change the air mass completely. So that thundery low clears out of the way. There it is across the eastern portion of Scotland, moving away to our east. And then we're opening the door to a much cooler and fresher airstream to head in from off the Atlantic with another area of low pressure in the middle part of the Atlantic. So we may still have more thunderstorms on Friday night into Saturday morning. Most storms could still be rumbling around in the northeast, in particular through the course of Saturday morning. Generally, they'll clear away, and then we're into a different air mass. It's a case of sunshine and showers. Some of those showers could be quite heavy and thundery, particularly so for the northwest. Probably few, if any, showers getting through to the southeast, and quite a brisk westerly wind. And that's really going to start to pull the humidity down, so it will feel much fresher on Saturday, albeit there will still be a lot of residual heat left in the east and the southeast. So temperatures in East England and South East England, despite this cooler, fresher air mass, could still reach around 25 degrees, actually, particularly for kind of like central London, where we've got lots of heat to get rid of out of the buildings and out of the ground. So a fresher feel, yes, but still potentially very warm in the South East. But from Wales and Midlands northwards, you will feel the difference on Saturday, most definitely, with much lower temperatures, just into below 20 Celsius, and definitely a much fresher feel as well. Then we go through to Sunday, and the next area of low pressure is moving in from off the Atlantic. This looks like quite a vigorous affair. The models are changing a little bit on how active this is going to be, but we could start off with cloud and general outbreaks of rain, which is something we've not had for a very long time across Ireland, Wales and southwest England. And overall, that wet weather looks like it's going to spread northwards and eastwards across much of the country through the day. East England and southeast England, still close to this ridge, could stay mainly dry, so very little rain getting through to the far southeast. But from Wales and the Midlands, north and west, expect cloud and outbreaks of rain. And some of that, particularly in the northwest, could be quite heavy, driven in by quite a strong westerly wind. So this is looking like a very different period, actually, coming up over weekend to what we've had for a long time. Temperatures in that persistent rain, probably no better, but around 16 or 17 degrees. Could still be very warm in the southeast, so still up to 25 degrees for East England and southeast England. And then we finish up the 5-day forecast period on Monday with that area of low pressure clearing away to the north of Scotland, leaving us in a cooler westerly flow with more showers. So there'll be showers in the north and west. The east will be mainly dry with sunny spells. Temperatures, well, it's going to feel fresher everywhere. Temperatures in the southeast up to around 24, 25 degrees. In the north and west, so probably seeing temperatures pegged down into the upper teens Celsius. Finally, just having a look at charts from Weather Outlook. So here's the situation today. Lots of dry and fine weather today. Hot in the southeast, and then we go through into tomorrow, and again a hot day but with an increasing risk of showers or thunderstorms beginning to break out. Showers or storms in eastern parts of the country, in particular on Friday. It'll be hot, very hot down in the southeast. We're going to a cooler and fresher period into the weekend with showers or longer spells of rain in the northwest, in particular, mainly dry in the southeast. We finish up on Monday with still some showers left, but also a fair amount of dry weather, and temperatures will be taking a little bit of a dip as well. So, in summary, well, it's going to start off hot to very hot over the next couple of days, but with a growing threat of heavy showers or thunderstorms. More on that in Storm Watch this evening. And then as we get through into the weekend, I think the temperature will cool down. It'll turn fresher, but still with some rain, particularly so in the north and the west. Today's second video will extend out beyond the 5-day forecast period, so come back for that this afternoon. But that's all for now. Thanks for watching.